or Europe to show their best on one of the most prestigious tournaments of the year. 2 days of incredible action in the MMA capital of Russia. October 20th and 21st, St. Petersburg, Russia, supported by the governor of the city. All data on WMMAA.org.
Добрый вечер, уважаемые дамы и господа. Всех поклонников боевых искусств мы рады приветствовать в столице смешанных боевых единоборств в России, городе Санкт-Петербург, где сегодня на одной из крупнейших спортивных площадок нашего города, в Ледовом дворце, состоится большой вечер самого мужественного вида спорта. Уже буквально через несколько мгновений стартуют финальные поединки чемпионата Европы по смешанному боевому единоборству ММА 2016 года. А в мейн-карде нашего турнира состоится очередной этап чемпионата мира по смешанным боевым единоборствам, грандиозный турнир M1 Challenge под номером 71. Будет интересно, будет жарко. Сегодня здесь, в Ледовом дворце, мы ожидаем аншлаг. Около 10 тысяч петербуржцев и гостей нашего города будут приветствовать спортсменов, которые будут подниматься в ринг уже очень и очень скоро. Вчера здесь, на этой арене, определились финалисты чемпионата Европы по ММА и Кубка губернатора Санкт-Петербурга. И уже сегодня все поклонники во всем мире, а нас будут транслировать больше, чем в 100 странах мира по традиции, узнают имена наших чемпионов. И, конечно же, мы будем болеть за команду Российской Федерации, но, разумеется, победит сильнейший. Так что следите за нашими поединками и, конечно, помогайте нашим спортсменам. От вашей горячей поддержки зависит очень и очень многое. Мы отдельно приветствуем и благодарны всем тем, кто в эти минуты прорвался сквозь городские пробки и уже здесь, на аренах Ледового дворца. Мы приветствуем всех тех, кто смотрит нас посредством теле- и интернет-порталов. Спасибо, что вы вместе с нами. Мы развиваем наш потрясающий, самый молодой, самый динамично развивающийся вид спорта в нашей стране, который мы очень надеемся и верим, что уже через несколько лет, а может быть и даже быстрее, станет олимпийским видом спорта. Но это о планах. А сегодня главный бой вечера. Противостояние экс-претендента на титул M1 Challenge в тяжелом весе Атила Вэй и экс-чемпион M1 Challenge в полутяжелом весе Виктор Немков. А также титульный бой в легчайшем весе между Павлом Витруком из России и Виталием Брончуком из Украины. Итак, дорогие друзья, добро пожаловать в Санкт-Петербург, Ледовый дворец, M1 Challenge 71 и чемпионат Европы по ММА 2016 года уже история. Мы начинаем, господа, я с огромным удовольствием хочу представить судей нашего турнира, аккредитованных Всемирной ассоциацией судей. Главный судья соревнований Павел Кан, Казахстан. Судья турнира Алексей Земсков, Россия. Судья турнира Лукаш Босацкий, Польша. Судья турнира Ян Воборник, Чехия. Судья турнира Виктор Корнеев, Россия. Судья турнира Вячеслав Киселев, Россия. Секретарь турнира Адель Файзулин, Россия. И судья-хронометрист, очаровательная Светлана Грозина. Итак, уважаемые дамы и господа, многоуважаемые поклонники боевых искусств, мы начинаем. Представляем вашему вниманию финал чемпионата Европы по смешанным боевым единоборствам ММА 2016 года. Весовая категория 61,3 килограмма. Представляем вам спортсмена в синем углу ринга.
Меня зовут Новицкий Владислав, единственный из нашей команды, кто вышел в финал. Тренируюсь в спортивном клубе «Аквариум» под руководством Пиварова Андрея Евгеньевича. Беларусь, вперед!
Дамы и господа, в синем углу ринга спортсмен из Республики Беларусь. Приветствуйте, Владислав Новицкий!
Мы любим свою страну, я уверен, по-своему, значит. Может, не как ты любим, но мы не можем иначе. Это наша земля, и она тут не виновата. Это наши края, это родина наша, ребят.
Дамы и господа, представляем спортсмена в красном углу ринга.
Меня зовут Костом Костомов. Я выступаю за сборную России. Провел 2 поединка и остался последний поединок, финальный поединок. И я сделаю все, чтобы Россия забрала у команды первое место и забрали мы кубок губернатора.
Приветствуйте, Касум Касумов, Россия!
Большого спорта и танца. Новая история, значит, и новый формат. Идет для молодых легенд, открытие врат. В мире смешанных боев и комбинированных атлет. Да это так, у нас стойных мужчин. Да это так, тут вера, воля, дух и патриотизм. Видать, избавлять вниз, но продолжить сражаться. Достижение цели, лучшая мотивация. Для чемпиона сквозь соперника кручила вдаль. Победа над собой, ему важнее, чем медаль. Небо ни сил, ни жаль, судьбы ударом держать. При неудаче на бойцов это и будет ждать. Каждый из нас в строю воин и уже чемпион. И нам не важно, клетка, ринг или октагон. Заряженный кулак, как боевой патрон. Подгон, новый заряд, подгона, новый прием.
Пересилить пацан, тут на весах победа и горечь и поражений. От старых достижений до следующей мишени. В любом из положений бить и быть на пике. Не только цель в конце, не слышать крики. Развеется мнение, кто лучший на этом ринге. И в чемпионской книге вписать себе список великих. Победа лучшая из всех наград. Бой не всегда по плану, но никогда наугад. Ты долго пахал, практикуя ударов град. Оппонент по спорту брат, с первой минуты не рад. Теперь поверь, узнай сполна. Может ли в тебе найти защиту родная страна. Каждому дана возможность выйти из народа и стать таким же легендарным воином, как Федор.
Казахи на Приволжских полях.
Союза мы правы.
Северо-западной до сибирских земель.
Россия, Союза мы правы.
Широколами до восточных морей.
Россия, Союза мы правы.
Идут войны, страны богатыри.
Россия, Союза мы правы.
Итак, господа, двухраундовый бой с возможным дополнительным третьим экстра-раундом. Позвольте представить вам спортсменов. Весовая категория, напомню, 61,3 килограмма. Спортсмен в синем углу ринга. Ему 25 лет. Рост 170 сантиметров. Он чемпион Республики Беларусь по смешанным боевым единоборствам. Приветствуйте, Владислав Новицкий! Республика Беларусь в силу! Его соперник в красном углу, ему 22 года, рост 165 сантиметров. Он чемпион Северного федерального. Серебряный призер чемпионата России по смешанным боевым единоборствам. Представляет Российскую Федерацию. Приветствуйте, Касум Касумов! Рефери в ринге Ян Воборник, Чехия.
Fighters?
Hey guys.
You know about the rules?
You have the 2 5-minute fights to try finish your opponent, please. Okay? So, no falls, fight fair, fight well. Don't attack our opponents on back of the head. Backbone or the knees, okay?
Set now for the bantamweight final of the 2016 WMMAA European Championships from Ice Palace in St. Petersburg, Russia. With Ian the Machine Freeman, I'm Sean Wheelock. Round number one. Vladislav Novitsky from Belarus, he's in the black trunks, versus Kasum Kasumov from Russia in the gray and red trunks.
Novitsky coming out first with the low kick there, Sean. And then these guys, they've already fought two fights yesterday to get to this final. So they'll either be very, very pumped to be in here today or they'll be very tired, but both guys looking extremely well on their feet.
Lots of lateral movement from Kasumov. Hands very high. Novitsky circling, trying to find the angle on his way to the inside.
Kasumov a little bit more static there than Novitsky. Nice low kick.
Novitsky staying on the outside. Good left jab.
Nice low kick.
Hands very high, as you see, for Kasumov. A lot of head movement for the Russian. 1-2, both missed from Novitsky. Swing and a miss with the right hand. Kasumov to the body.
Yeah, nice body shot there, setting him up.
And Kasumov very disciplined with his guard, hands very high.
The thing with Novitsky, his head is quite stiff and his chin is up in the air. He doesn't keep it down, he doesn't keep it tucked away like Kasumov. He's a little bit of an open target, but there's the double.
On the shot for the double leg by Kasumov. Novitsky trying to sprawl. Takedown lands. Good. From Kasumov.
Yeah, Kasumov from the hard guard. Novitsky trying to turn him. A little bit of an awkward position, but he's going to get it. He can go for crucifix from here. And he's quite happy to just keep hold of the body, Sean. Trying to do like a stalling tactic more than anything else. He could really turn and get out on his knees if he wanted to.
Kasumov trying to step over, trying to reach through.
Stay busy, guys. Stay busy.
Well, Novitsky had all the chance in the world to turn him there, but he was quite content to just keep a hold of the body. He's looking for the referee to stand it. He should have turned him. Kasumov gets his head free.
Referee Jan Voronik taking this close look. Happy to see plenty of action as we continue. 2:35 remaining round number one. This an all-tournament finals scheduled for 2 5-minute rounds. Level on the three judges' scorecards after two rounds. We will go to a third and decisive overtime round. Hammer fist from Kasumov.
Yeah, Kasumov's throwing the hammer fist, but he's got an arm trapped there. He needs to cross fist and pull that arm out.
Kasumov working out of the half guard of Novitsky. Novitsky just trying to hold on, controlling on the left arm.
As long as Kasumov is throwing him hammer fists, referee will not stand it, no matter how long Nowitzki keeps hold of that arm.
Kasumov trying to throw the right hand to the head. Ian, just no real offensive grappling from the bottom from Nowitzki. Holding tight on the half guard and trying to control the left arm of Kasumov.
To be honest, watching Kasumov, he could slip that leg free if he wanted and step over to mount position, because the half guard is not really tight, but he's quite happy, quite content, just the hammer fist. You know, he's winning the round, he's doing really well with the ground and pound. But if he wanted to, he could slip out of there. It's not really a very tight close guard.
Good right hand after missing the hammer fist. Now a right hand to the body from Kasumov. Throwing with the right hand is his left arm still trapped by Nowitzki.
And again, if he wanted to, we could pull that arm out. There we go. Because I was going to say, he only had a hold of it with one arm. If he had a hold with two, it'd be a lot harder to pull the arm free. But I think he's quite happy to just stay in this half guard and hammer fist away.
Left hand getting through a moment ago in this sequence. That right hammer fist getting through. 55 seconds remaining, round number one. All from the lone takedown attempt. Successfully hit on the second effort from Kasumov. Now holding this top position, continuing the fight out of the half guard of Vladislav Nowitzki. Hammer fist starting to find their way through from Kasumov. Just like that with the right hand.
Yeah, Nowitzki needs to do something different and hang on to this half guard position. He's just taking punishment now.
As the bottom fighter, you cannot stall and force the stand-up. The stand-up comes from the inactivity of the top fighter, and you see a lot of activity from Kasumov.
Well, he knows that as well, Sean. He's throwing his hammer fist. He knows it's scoring points. He's won this round, clearly. So he's quite happy to stay there. Remember, like we said, two rounds only in this amateur fight, so he's going to go win one more, and that's it. He's there. He's done. But a great, great position there for Kasumov.
That is the end of round number one of this bantamweight final.
Now the referee is warning Nowitzki more on the defense. And there's that beautiful body shot there by Kasumov. Kasumov worked really well, gets a nice takedown. Takedown lands him straight into half guard. And that is where the first round basically started and finished. Kasumov in top position, half guard, pummeling away at Nowitzki.
You see in the corner of Kasumov.
Good.
Kasumov just said to you and me, good. He gave us a wink. Feeling very good about round number one. There's Marco Brewerson of the Netherlands, the chief official. 2016 WMMAA European Championships here in St. Petersburg, Russia. Headed into round number two.
Ready? Fight!
Well, Nowitzki has to try something different here, Sean. He was outclassed on the feet and definitely outclassed on the ground. Maybe needs to try a takedown of his own, but no. Gets caught in a double again, straight back onto the canvas.
Two attempts, two successful takedowns for Kasumov. Hit the one in round number one. Now hits that 15 seconds into round number two. Nothing on that guillotine position.
No, he's in the half guard. It's going to be very hard to apply this guillotine from there.
Kasumov about to pop his head free, and he does on cue.
Well, carbon copy of round one, Sean, half guard. Now full guard. Now let's see what does Nowitzki have from his back regarding submissions.
Round number one, Ian, we saw Nowitzki just aggressively not leaps, not looking to attack with the legs from the bottom position.
And to be honest, that tells me that he's not that skilled on the submission side of the game. That's why I was thinking he may need a takedown of his own, get in top position, try some ground and pound. But you never know, he's got a hold of the arm there, maybe trying for the arm bar. But no, he's just holding the head.
Nowitzki walking his guard up. Kasumov with the left hand, that doesn't get through. Now raising his head up, looking for striking distance. Nowitzki being a little more aggressive with his guard. Warm under the chin, nicely done from Kasumov. Smart and legal, and now lands the right hand.
Yeah, Kasumov doing well. Notice how he keeps his hands on the inside. Keeps your hand on the inside, that means you can't really get tied up with anything. Leaves your hands free to be able to throw the strikes. So there's body head. Nice hammer fist.
Davinsky again closing his guard, walking it up, but not attacking with the legs. He didn't attack with the legs in the half guard round number one, and he's not attacking at all with this closed guard here in round number two. Just recrosses the ankles.
Yeah, he did have a half-hearted attempt of an armbar, but it was a half-hearted attempt. I don't think it would be enough to catch somebody in an armbar.
Kasumov looking very comfortable in this top position. Good wide base on his knees. Now raising up, looking for the hammer fist. You see no triangle attempt from Nowitzki, keeping the low guard. Low guard. Now clearing the legs and passing into side control is Kasumov.
Yeah, this is more dangerous now.
Kasumov sitting through on his hip.
Yeah, he's actually trying to trap the arm. He's going to go for crucifix position in side control, trying to trap that arm against his legs.
Walking up, looking for crucifix, is Kasumov. The trap on the left arm of Nowitzki.
Nowitzki trying to re-guard.
Good hammer fist. Nicely done by Nowitzki, but again, it's defense. It's Kasumov on offense for the vast majority of this fight.
Well, Kasumov has been in top position for nearly 3 minutes now. Nice reversal attempt though. Nowitzki trying it, but he's just too static on his back, Sean. He's not really doing any sort of submission or reversal attempt back to the half guard. And we know that Kasumov enjoyed the half guard. He's just going to finish this round off strong again.
Kasumov very comfortable fighting out of the half guard, as you see now, lands the right hand to the head. Hammer fist. All offense from Kasumov of Russia. All defense from Vladislav Nowitzki of Belarus.
Nice head control as well there by Kasumov. Nowitzki with his head flat to the canvas. It's not where you want to be when you're on your back. You never want to have your head flat to the canvas. You want to have a little bit of recoil. Put your chin to your chest, keep your head off the canvas, so when you do get hit, there's a little bit of recoil to take that pressure away. Nice big right hands.
Saw a good look from the closed guard of Nowitzki, but it's so defensive on that closed half guard.
Pass
nice
again.
Pass into side control for Kasumov. Final minute of this round. Will this be the final minute of this bantamweight tournament final?
Kasumov throwing knees to the body now. The only arsenal he hasn't used is that mount position, which I wouldn't be surprised if he stepped over. 40 seconds left to go, but he's in a strong position, Sean. He'd be happy to steer here inside.
Kasumov walking up the body inside control.
Oh,
big
nice
left hammer fist in another. Strong showing now from Kasumov. He can sense this victory. He can sense this tournament victory.
He knows he's got this, Sean. It's been two strong rounds. Side control position now. With 10 seconds left to go, he's just going to punch it out. He's going to punch it out to the victory, I feel.
Almost put knee on belly, continuing to throw. You see the big, wide, strong base on his knees from Kasumov. And that's the end of the round, and most likely the end of this bantamweight final. Again, we do have the possibility of an overtime round. If it's scored level after these two rounds on the three judges' scorecards, Ian, I don't think that's going to be the case.
I'd be very surprised if it was. I mean, that was two strong, dominant rounds there by Kasumov.
Two takedown attempts, one in round one, one in round two, both successfully hit by Kasumov. And Nowitzki never had an answer. From those takedowns, he could never get up.
He couldn't get up. I mean, it all depends on how hard was these two fights that he had yesterday. He had two fights to get into this final. It could be exhausted, it could be injured even, but that was a dominant, dominant fight there by Kasumov.
Советник губернатора Санкт-Петербурга по вопросам физической культуры и спорта молодежной политики Андрей Семенов, а также... Для награждения бронзовых призеров мы приглашаем нас в ринг обладателей третьих мест. Радим Наврузов из Грузии, а также Евгений Бондарь из Украины.
Through the two rounds in 10 minutes, two good takedowns from Kasumov. What really impressed me, Ian, was his top... Five guard, very comfortable, never in danger of being triangled, never in danger of being swept.
What was good as well was the hammer fists. I mean, these are amateurs. Not many amateurs use the hammer fist. They just go for the big power shots, but he controlled it. He did well. And now we hand it over to your MC for the final.
Уважаемые поклонники смешанных боевых единоборств. по итогам двух раундов. В этом поединке одержал победу и стал чемпионом Европы по смешанному боевому единоборству ММА 2016 года в весовой категории 61,3 килограмма спортсмен из России Касум Касума! Наши поздравления, наши аплодисменты, наши приветствия чемпиону Касум Касума Россия. Мы аплодируем и поздравляем спортсмена из Республики Беларусь. Он занял второе место и стал серебряным призером чемпионата Европы. Владислав Новицкий, Республика Беларусь. Ну и, конечно же, мы поздравляем спортсменов, которых стало двое. Они завоевали третье место, стали бронзовыми призерами. Бронзовые призеры Радим Наврузов и спортсмен из Украины Денис Бондарь. Спасибо огромное. Общее фото на память. И наши аплодисменты первым героям, первым победителям. Спасибо огромное. Андрей Владимирович, Вадим Григорьевич, останьтесь на несколько мгновений в ринге, если не возражаете, слово нашему первому победителю сегодняшнего праздника спорта.
Ассаламу алейкум всем. Добрый вечер, Санкт-Петербург. Хотел у всех поблагодарить, кто пришел меня поддержать, кто смотрит, кто болеет. Всем большое спасибо. Эту победу я хотел посвятить своим родителям, которые так ждали этого момента. Вот и настало это время. Еще я хотел поблагодарить главу республики Рамзана Ахмадовича Кадырова, президента клуба, бойцовского клуба Ахмад Абузайдова Исмурадова и моего старшего брата и тренера Шамиля Заурова. Всем им большое спасибо. Отдельное спасибо хотел сказать коллективу Союза ММА, всем главному тренеру Геннадию Капшаю, старшему тренеру Шамилю Алибатырову, Владимиру Ося, Андрею Терентьеву и нашей многоуважаемой Елене Павловне, нашему врачу. Мы одна семья. Спасибо всем большое.
Спасибо. Касум Касумов, Россия! Спасибо огромное. Андрей Владимирович, мы уже говорили о том, что сегодня команда-победитель получит кубок с губернатора Санкт-Петербурга. Это впервые в нашей истории. Скажите несколько слов, пожалуйста.
Ну, во-первых, хочу бы приветствовать Ледовый. Хотя народу у нас пока еще не собралось в полное количество, но все впереди. Самое интересное, я думаю, будет впереди. Вот у нас есть уже первый победитель, первый чемпион. Поэтому хочу, чтобы вы зарядились положительной энергией и вам прежде всего понравились здесь бои. Спасибо.
Ну, хочу добавить, что я вижу, что Fight Card заполнен российскими атлетами, поэтому большой шанс, что кубок останется здесь, в России.
Будем на это надеяться и будем болеть, кто победит сильнейший. Спасибо, Вадим Финкельштейн, Андрей Семенов. Спасибо! Спасибо вам за поддержку. По традиции мы хотим сказать слова благодарности нашим партнерам и спонсорам. Невская Ком – крупнейшая компания по поставке широкого ассортимента свежих фруктов и овощей по всей России, более чем из 25 стран мира. Невская Ко – профессионализм и качество. Благодарю за внимание. Уважаемые поклонники смешанных боевых единоборств, представляем вашему вниманию финальный бой чемпионата Европы по ММА 2016 года. Весовая категория до 65,8 килограмма. Представляем спортсмена в синем углу ринга.
Всем привет, меня зовут Владислав Задерко, я представляю сборную Украины по ММА. Я провел несколько сложных поединков и очень рад, что попал в финал. Надеюсь стать чемпионом Европы. Всем спасибо.
В синем углу ринга спортсмен из Украины. Приветствуйте, Владислав Задерко!
I ain't gonna eat, I ain't gonna sleep, ain't gonna breathe till I see what I wanna see. And what I wanna see is you gonna sleep in the dirt. Permanently, you just being hurt. This ain't gonna work for me, it just wouldn't be sufficient enough to speak. Or just gonna be enemies as long as we breathe. I don't ever see either of us coming to terms. We can agree, there ain't gonna be no reason speaking with me. You think of my seat, then me, no second in glass. So we gonna beef and keep on beefing and less. You're gonna agree to meet with me in the flesh and settle this face to face. And you're gonna see a demon unleashed in me that you never seen. And you're gonna see this chance to be on himself. I see you these round with things, but me need no help. Me do this one of my homies. I don't even see my homies. When I see you, I'm seeing you. Me and you only. We never met. Best believe you gonna know me when I'm this close. To see you exposed and phony. Come on, bitch, show me. Pick me up, throw me. Lift me up, hold me.
Господа, представляю вам спортсмена в красном углу ринга.
Я Набиа Шаралаев, представляю сборную России по ММА. Провел несколько тяжелых боев и попал в финал. И Россия вперед.
Спортсмен в красном углу ринга. Приветствуйте, Набиа Шаралаев, Россия!
Большого спорта и танца. Новая история, значит и новый формат. Ведет для молодых легенд открытие врат. В мире смешанных боев и комбинированных атак. Да это так, спорт достойных мужчин. Да это так, тут вера, воля, дух и патриотизм. Летать и падать вниз, но продолжить сражаться. Достижение цели, лучшая мотивация. Для чемпиона спорт соперника кружила вдаль. Победа над собой ему важнее, чем медаль. Нет боли, сил не жаль, судьбы удар держать. При неудаче на против пытаясь побежать. Каждый из нас свою воин и уже чемпион. И нам не важно клетка ринг или октагон. Заряженный кулак, как боевой батон. Подгон, новый заряд, с погоном новый прием.
Отборка в Казани, нам тревожки пари. Россия, Союз, ММА, север, западный, на сибирский зиме. Россия, Союз, ММА, все широкие на восточной пари. Россия, Союз, ММА, идут войны, страны богатыри. Россия, Союз, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА, ММА,
империи настрой бойца. Готовы всех врагов пересилить по отцам. Тут на весах победа и горечь поражений. А старые достижения до следующей мишени. В любом из положений пить и быть на пике. И только цель в конце не слышать крики. Развеет сомнения, кто лучший на этом ринге. И в чемпионской книге писать себе список великий. Победа лучшая из всех наград. Бой не всегда по плану, но никогда наугад. Ты долго пахал, подчеркну я ударом в край. Оппонент по сколку брат, первые минуты не раз. Теперь не поверь, узнай сполна. Может ли тебе найти защиту родная страна. Каждому дана возможность выйти из дорога и стать таким же легендарным воином, как Фёдор.
Итак, уважаемые поклонники боевых искусств, представляем вам двухраундовый бой с возможным дополнительным третьим экстра-раундом. Весовая категория 65,8 килограмма. Представляю вам спортсменов. Спортсмен в синем углу, ему 25 лет. Рост 170 сантиметров. Он чемпион Украины по смешанным боевым единоборствам. Приветствуйте, Владислав Затирка, Украина! И его соперник в красном углу, ему 22 года, рост 171 сантиметр. Он победитель Кубка России по ММА, обладатель Суперкубка России по ММА. Представляет Российскую Федерацию. Приветствуйте, Наби Ашурлаев в красном углу. Рефери в ринге Вячеслав Киселев, Санкт-Петербург, Россия.
Бойцы, Сирина. Итак, это финальный бой. Два раунда по 5 минут, возможен третий дополнительный раунд. Правила помним, не нарушаем. Внимательно слушаем мои команды, деремся активно на протяжении всего боя. Руки пожали. По углам.
Set now for the featherweight final, the 2016 WMMAA European Championships from Ice Palace in St. Petersburg, Russia. Владислав Затирка from Ukraine versus Наби Ашурлаев from Russia. Round number one. Black trunks for Затирка, green red trunks for Ашурлаев.
Oh, nice body kick by Затирка. Yeah. Immediately going for the liver.
Затирка just missing with that outside kick. Immediately putting Ашурлаев on the defensive, Ian, with that body kick to open this fight.
Yeah, he keeps switching stance as well, going from orthodox to southpaw. Nice jumping knee, straight away going for the double.
Step in knee, that's used to close distance. Now looking for the takedown is Ашурлаев, and he hits it. Trying to pass in the side control, hooking the leg. Затирка trying to find his guard.
Yeah, Затирка had a butterfly. He actually lost it, which was a better position for him to be in. He could have gotten a sweep with that butterfly.
Ашурлаев posturing up, now standing up off of his left knee. Looking for striking range.
The guard is wide open by Затирка. He could easily pass if he wanted. Push that leg down. Get around the side control.
Затирка, you see, based up against between the bottom rope and the base of the cage on the fence. Good left hand.
Ашурлаев now in half guard.
Ашурлаев short, sharp left hand. Yeah, continuing to spin and move, looking for side control.
Nice wizard as well. That's controlling his opponent.
Затирка posturing on his hip, tenaciously holding on the half guard. About to lose it, Ашурлаев trying to stand up out of half guard, and now he pulls his right leg free.
Ashulayev's got a strong wizard. That's the overarm hook under the armpit. Затирка gets back to his feet. Great work. He's got a high crotch. He could pick him up here.
Knee to the thigh from Затирка. Spin by Ашурлаев. 2 minutes gone, round number one of this featherweight tournament final. Counter knee from Ашурлаев. With a lot of pressure, you see Затирка at defensive base against the ropes. Can't avoid the second takedown of this fight. Nicely done by Ашурлаев. He's very committed, drives his head forward on the takedowns.
Oh, big, strong right hand.
That second right got through, landed flush. Now the left hand. Тирка again on his hips. Eats that left hand. Locking up half guard from his hip. But eats another big left hand. That with the hammer fist from Ashurlayev.
So Tika trying to pull guard, but now getting back to his feet. Good work. But nice body lock there, Ashurlayev. Ashurlayev's going to sit back. No, he doesn't. But the knees are coming in well by Satakira.
Tirka landed that knee back against the ropes. Trading knees now, Ashurlayev and Zatirka. Then a right to the body from Ashurlayev. 150 remaining round number one. In for the outside trip. Yeah, Ashurlayev nearly hit it.
That was the trip he tried earlier, but he missed it. Missed it once again. Rook kept him standing.
See Ashurlayev attacking the thigh with those short, sharp knees.
Ashurlayev's got a full body lock.
Zatirka opened this featherweight tournament final with a powerful body kick. Since then, largely, he's been playing defense.
He needs to get away from the ropes. That's what he needs to do, Sean, because the grappler is controlling this fight up against them ropes. He needs to break free, use those nice body kicks again. Ashurlayev, good head control.
Good head position from Navi Ashurlayev. Staying very tight, but he eats that knee from Zatirka. It was hard. And right hand to the body from Ashurlayev. Ashurlayev holding the counter body lock. Overhook on the right side from Vladislav Zatirka.
Them knees are going in beautiful, aren't they? Every time there's an opening, Zatirka just throws that knee to the body. Although it's not going to score him very well with the judges because his back is up against the ropes so much. There's a takedown.
Getting high on the thighs and hitting that takedown successfully. Nicely done by Ashurlayev. Zatirka been unable to mount any type of takedown defense thus far in this fight. On the scoop, controlling the hips to get that takedown. Close guard now from Vladislav Zatirka. Final seconds, round number one. Ashurlayev burying his head now, trying to walk up through the close guard. Misses with the right and the left. Trying to throw kick before the bell.
Well, a good round for Ashurlayev. Totally strong. Like I said, he took punishment at the beginning, right at the beginning with the body kick. But then after that, it was all Ashurlayev. There's that jumping knee, that closes the gap. And again from a different angle, throws the knee just to close the gap, gets the double, takes it down, and there's the beautiful knees by Ashurlayev, but his back was up against the ropes. It doesn't really score very well in the eyes of the judges when your back's against the ropes, no matter how much punishment you're thrown out. You're being controlled, you're up against the ropes, you need to break free. And I think this is the tactic he has to play in round two. He needs to keep away from the clinch, keep his distance, use those legs, work on the body kicks, which he did in the beginning of round one.
Vadim Finkelstein, the head of M1 Global, 2016 WMMAA European MMA Championships, part of M1 and M1 Challenge 71 here at Ice Palace in St. Petersburg, Russia. Headed into round number two of this featherweight tournament final. Vladislav Zatirka from Ukraine versus Navi Ashurlayev from right here in Russia. Vyacheslav Kiselov starts us for round number two.
There's the kicks we're talking about, Sean. Needs to keep his distance. He doesn't want to get in the clinch. Zatirka is just too good in the clinch. Dominates, got good takedowns, and there we have it again. Nice takedown.
Off
now
of the
takes
outside.
It back.
And off of the outside kick, Ian, Ashurlayev was willing to take the outside kick, time that takedown beautifully. Four takedown attempts in this fight from Navi Ashurlayev, and he has hit all four. Showed decent ground control. Looking for a seatbelt position from the top. Now trying to move to the back.
Well, he threw a knee to the body there, Sean. I thought he was going to try and get his hooks in, but... Oh!
But Vladislav Zatirka back to his feet, but caught in this waist cinch from Ashurlayev.
Ashurlayev is just relentless with that takedown attempt. Oh, he's got it now.
Again on the scoop on the double leg, controlling the legs. See trouble with the canvas in the corner. It's not bothering Nabi Ashurlayev. Continuing to walk through is Zatyrka, caught in a very difficult position against the turnbuckle and against the lower fence.
Yeah, the referee will be keeping a close eye on this canvas.
Stop!
Yeah, he's stopping the fight. Well, just to let people know that this is just a temporary canvas while the amateur tournament is going ahead. Underneath that is the M1 challenge canvas, which is securely fixed.
So time called by referee Vyacheslav Kiselev. Try to sort out the canvas the best they can. And I imagine Kiselev will restart them from the ground rather than in the stand-up position.
Well, you would think he would, because obviously that is unfortunate that the canvas has come up, so they've got to start the action where it finished. But depending how long this canvas is going to take, they may start it from the beginning, standing from the middle.
If I'm in the corner of Nabi Ashurlayev, I'm emphatic to the referee Vyacheslav Kiselev, start back from the ground. Zatyrka on the bottom, and he was pushed against the turnbuckle, against the base of the fence.
Well, that's the worst position you can be in, up against the turnbuckle. You know, when if they start from the center, then he's got more chance of reversal, submissions, and stand-up.
Zatyrka getting advice from his corner. That should not be allowed during a timeout. Ashurlayev is in a neutral corner, opposite from his corner. But Zatyrka's Ukrainian corner has come over to the neutral corner to give him instruction. It's legal if you can get away with it, Machine.
It's only legal if you can get away with it. But to be honest, Ashurlayev has just got to do the same thing as he's been doing. The takedowns have been super fast. The body locks have been good. Once he's in a body lock and he's got his body close to his opponent, he just can't move.
So we're in a timeout situation here in round number two of this featherweight tournament final. To fix the canvas again, as Ian the Machine Freeman said, this is a temporary amateur canvas on top of the pro canvas, which will be used later this evening here in St. Petersburg, Russia, for M1 Challenge 71.
And here we see, he's basically just trying to push as hard as he can to keep his opponent up against the corner post. And obviously his feet scraping across the floor, has ripped up the canvas. I think it's just stapled onto the side, Sean. I don't think it's really fixed solid. Because once the amateurs are finished, they will just pull that off. And the canvas that's underneath is a fixed solid canvas.
So the canvas appears to be sorted. Now we'll see where Vyacheslav Kiselev decides to restart this fight.
On its feet.
That definitely favors Vladislav Zatyrka. He'll try to take full advantage. There's a shot on the single leg.
Well, that was an intelligent shot, to be honest, because he's not very good from his back. Ashurlayev was dominating the top position. So Zatyrka decides to take a double himself.
Looking for an omoplata now is Ashurlayev. Zatyrka defending that takedown, wound up on top position, but now looking for the omoplata. Nicely done by Ashurlayev.
Yeah,
now
inside control.
Inside control.
Well, we know he's definitely got the better ground, Ashurlayev.
Close guard now for Zatyrka.
Zatyrka actually dominated the takedown, but it was just reversed by Ashurlayev at the last moment. Throwing knees from the guard. Oh, big right hand there. Ashurlayev doing strong.
Standing up out of guard, now landing to the body. You see Nabi Ashurlayev trying to clear the legs, and he does with that left hand flush into the face of Zatyrka.
Zatyrka's turning the wrong way. He needs to be careful. He's trying to turn away from the punishment. Nearly gave his back, but now in full guard.
Full closed guard. Ashurlayev very active from top position. You see, trying to walk through, knee to the thigh. That was smart. Body head with the right hand. Body that time with the right hand from Ashurlayev.
Zatyrka just doesn't have any answer whatsoever for this ground and pound. The Thunderous, they're coming in strong now.
Руки контролируй, контролируй обе руки.
I like the way Ashulayev controls the head before he throws them punches.
Rajiv punches from Ashulayev. Here's up. Can you see a difficult position in the corner of the ring against the base of that lower fence on his hips, trying to scramble up, trying to get to his feet. Ashulayev, too heavy, too controlling with that top position.
Ashulayev, the way he's controlling the head, you control the head, you control all the body of your opponent. Every time that Satika tried to stand up, he controls the head. Once you control the head, you cannot move the rest of your body, and that's what's keeping him down on the canvas.
Final minute of round number two. Get the possibility of an overtime round, but it looks like this might be the final minute of this fight. Barring a finish from Vladislav Zatyrka, Rabi Ashulayev has looked very strong in this featherweight tournament final, but nothing decided yet. Body from Zatyrka and another.
Yeah, same as round one, throwing the knees from his back up against the cage. Nice takedown, he's going to get it. Yeah, every single takedown he's attempted, he's tried it, he's got it.
Then you see again Ian controlling the hips on the scoop, on the lift and the full takedown. Textbook from Nabi Ashulayev. 15 seconds now to what looks to be the end of this fight. Nabi Ashulayev in his corner certainly feel that they've done enough to win this featherweight tournament final in this championship. Stepping over, looking for one more right hand, the flurry of punches.
Oh, with the right hand. Right on the bell.
There is the bell.
Ashulayev asking for the flag to celebrate. He knows he's got it.
В ринг приглашаются бронзовые призеры весовой категории 65,8 килограмма. Ими стали Виталий Андрухович из Республики Беларусь и Арчил Тазяшвили, Грузия. Для награждения спортсменов в ринг приглашаются президент Федерации ММА Азербайджана Равшан Гасанов, а также президент Федерации ММА Кореи Ким Джан Джун.
We are now set to learn the winner of this featherweight tournament final.
Бойцы на середину. Уважаемые поклонники боевых искусств, в этом поединке по итогам двух раундов единогласным решением судей одержал победу и стал чемпионом Европы по ММА весовой категории 65,8 килограмма спортсмен из России Наби Ашурваев. Первое место. Наши аплодисменты и, конечно же, награда победителю. И лучшей наградой победителю, конечно же, будут ваши аплодисменты, друзья. Давайте поддержим спортсмена. Мы поддержим нашу всю сборную. И еще один балл, еще одно очко в победную копилку сборной команды России. Спасибо огромное. Наби Ашурлаев, весовая категория 65,8 килограмма. Второе место. Спортсмен из Украины Владислав Затерка. Наши аплодисменты. Спасибо за поединок. Владислав, спасибо всей украинской сборной за борьбу. Спасибо, ребята. Ну и, конечно же, бронзовые призеры. Они тоже здесь, в ринге. Мы их приветствуем, аплодируем и вручаем заслуженные награды. Виталий Андрухович, Беларусь. Арчил Тазяшвили, Грузия. Традиционное фото на память. А мы еще раз аплодируем нашим спортсменам. Благодарим за поединки. Спасибо вам и добро пожаловать в Россию и в Санкт-Петербург. Поздравляем! Ура! Ну и по традиции. президент Федерации ММА Азербайджана Равшан Гасанов.
Добрый вечер, Санкт-Петербург. Поздравляю победителей чемпионата Европы. Поздравляю финалистов, которые ждут своих боев. И хочу поблагодарить президента Всемирной организации Вадима Финкельштейна за такой большой праздник спорта. Спасибо вам, Вадим Григорьевич.
Спасибо огромное, Равшан. Спасибо огромное, Ким Джанчжун, Корея. Спасибо. Thank you very much. Северин Телеком, один из лидеров рынка корпоративной связи Северо-Западного федерального округа. Северин Телеком доверяет крупнейшей компании предприятия города. Северин Телеком – это качественная надежная связь на самых выгодных условиях. Северин Телеком – связь для бизнеса.
Бизнес FM Петербург. Первое деловое радио. 107.4 FM. Наш бизнес новости.
Кто же победит Бабулина? Вот это интрига.
Всех приветствую, коротко о главном.
Даже не представляете, кто сейчас в нашей студии.
И такое может быть только на Спорт.ФМ.
Слушай Спорт.ФМ в Санкт-Петербурге. Будь первым.
Уважаемые поклонники боевых искусств, представляем вашему вниманию финальный бой чемпионата Европы по смешанному боевому единоборству ММА 2016 года в весовой категории 70,3 килограмма. Представляем спортсмена в синем углу ринга.
Mein Name ist Michael Ovsyannikov, ich bin 21 Jahre alt, ich trainiere bei Integra Fight Wittlich und kämpfe für die deutsche Nationalmannschaft. Ich werde alles dafür tun, um die Goldmedaille mit nach Deutschland zu holen.
В синем углу ринга спортсмен представляет Германию. Приветствуйте, Мишель Овсянников! Дамы и господа, в красном углу ринга спортсмен из России. Внимание на экран!
Меня зовут Шамиль Мусаев, выступаю за сборную России. Тренирую в клубе Golden Team под руководством Владимира Осия. Представляю центральный спортивный клуб армии ЦСКА. Я в финале, Россия вперед.
Приветствуйте, Шамиль Мусаев, Россия!
конца. Новые истории я зачитываю. Молодых легенд, открытие врат, пересеженных боев и комбинированных атак. Да это так, сто достойных мужчин, да это так. Тут вера, воля, дух и патриотизм. Видать, избавлять вниз, но продолжать остаться. Достижение цели, лучшая мотивация. Для чемпиона, сколь соперника, кружит рука. Победа над собой, ему важнее, чем медаль. Нет боли, сил, не жаль, судьбы удар держать. Вы неудачи, на подъем подарить, подержать. Каждый из нас, свою воин, и уже чемпион. Нам не важно, клетка и или октагон. Заряженный кулак, как боевой батон. Батон, новый заряд, подбор, новый прием.
Итак, господа, двухраундовый бой, возможно, был отделен третьим экстра-раундом. Весовая категория 73 килограмма. Представляю вам спортсменов. Спортсмен в синем углу. Ему 28 лет, рост 172 сантиметра. Он чемпион Германии по грэпплингу. Чемпион Германии по ММА. Приветствуйте, Мишель Овсянников, Германия! Его соперник в красном углу, ему 22 года, рост 173 сантиметра. Он серебряный призер чемпионата России по ММА. Представляет Российскую Федерацию. Приветствуйте, Шамиль Мусаев! Рефери в ринге Лукаш Босацкий, Польша.
Fighters in the center. Okay, fighters, know the rules. Listen to my commands all the time. When I say stop, we stop. Touch goes. Go back to your corners.
Here we go now with the lightweight final, the 2016 WMMAA European Championships.
Ready?
From St. Petersburg,
ready?
Russia.
Fight.
The bell in round number one. Mikhail Ovsyannikov from Germany, he's in the black trunks. Shamil Mousaev from right here in Russia is in the gray and red trunks. Ovsyannikov already trying to establish his jab, Ian.
Yeah, Ovsyannikov looks like he's got good stand-up. All over, he just started. You can tell by the stance. You can tell by the movement. You can tell by the lateral movement, the hand speed. Looking quite good.
Ovsyannikov very disciplined with the right hand, as you see. High to the chin. Continues to throw that left jab.
Oh, big overhand right.
By design, Mousaev, the overhand right, looking for the body lock. To the takedown. Half well, butterfly guard for Ovsyannikov.
Ovsyannikov actually went for the inside trip, and that put him off balance. Mousaev then took him down and took advantage of it. We're now trying to pass the guard. The side control is Mousaev.
Still working out of the half butterfly guard is Ovsyannikov.
Full butterfly now. Ovsyannikov, he could elevate. Decides to go high with the legs. But I like what Mousaev is doing. He's trying to pass. A lot of guys just sit in the guard when they're amateur. They just sit in the guard, throw punches. He's trying to pass. He's trying to dominate the position, trying to get in a better position for striking or submissions.
We just saw a call for action from our Polish referee, Łukasz Bosacki. Outstanding referee trying to move this fight along. Mousaev staying very close, chest to chest, very conservative, not quite putting himself in striking range.
Ovsyannikov doing really well though, he's spoiling the punches. Going to try and step through. Ovsyannikov's going to look for a triangle here. Oh, he goes for it, but takes punishment. Took a big right hand as he went for the triangle.
Mousaev stacking his opponent, nearly put himself, as you said, Ian, in triangle danger. Good job though on this stack from Shamil Mousaev. Open guard now for Ovsyannikov.
Mousaev using nice head control. That's a little bit better for Mousaev as well, pushing his opponent's head up against the cage part of the ring.
and actually lifting off Sionikov, Ian, into that lower fence. Smart move.
Well, if your head is like cramped up in a 45 degree position, which it is, that's why Sionikov moved to the side there. When your head is cramped up like that, it's very hard to move your legs and try submission attempts.
20 remaining round number one of this lightweight tournament final.
Musayev is very patient. He's not rushing anything. He's taking his time, making sure that every punch counts.
Open guard still for the German, Mikhail Ovsyannikov. Trying to be active out of this open guard.
Legs are going high by Ovsyannikov. I thought he was going to try and come up and go for Google Plotter, Omar Plotter.
Big hammer fist with the left hand from Shamil Musayev. The body with the right hand from the Russian Musayev. Those are thudding shots to the body.
Yeah, he's comfortable now, Musayev. He tried to pass guard position right at the beginning, but he realizes that there's no submission attempts coming his way, so he's quite happy to sit here. There's one submission attempt again.
Sionikov again trying to walk up with his left leg, just not finding any joy, any success. Back to open guard. See the blood on the right elbow of Sionikov.
Musayev is posturing up as well. See how he's putting his leg up there? That gives him just a little bit more posture to throw power down with the punches. One of the disadvantages to that, if the opponent knows how to do knee bars from there, you can get caught in a knee bar, but he's quite happy to lift the leg up, Musayev, and gain extra power through them punches.
Big shots with the right hand now from Musayev. 50 seconds remaining, round number one. Very defensive posture for Mikhail Ovsyannikov. Stuck on the bottom.
Ovsyannikov is doing really well, as in he's trying the attempts. He's not just holding on. He's not just hanging on for Desperado. He's actually trying. You can see what he's looking for. You can see the submissions that he's looking for. It's just Musayev is just too clued up. He knows what he's doing. He's controlling this fight. He's controlling it really well. And look how he's keeping his opponent up against the ridge, up against the cage part of this ring.
Another big left hand. Wide base on his knees to do just that. Lands big effective strikes from this top position.
Finishing strong. Total domination there by Musayev.
The bell at the end of round one. Nice bit of sportsmanship. The two fighters touch gloves. Easier to touch gloves when you've won the round.
Yeah, well, Musayev definitely won that round. Like I say, a strong top position. Totally controlled. Try to pass the guard at first, but this is a nice takedown. It's the inside trip was spoiled, and Musayev took advantage of it. Put his opponent off balance, took him to his back. But this is a wise decision to do. Put his head up against the cage, up against the cage part of the ring. Your head is at an angle. Very hard to pull submissions off and move out the way. Ovsyannikov needs to try a different attack in the second round now.
Seconds out, Cole.
Seconds out.
Headed into round number two of this lightweight tournament final. Mikhail Ovsyannikov versus Shamil Musayev.
Go.
Gosh, Posadsky, our excellent referee, wiping down Musayev. His corner absolutely drenching him in water.
Don't do that again.
Can create an unfair advantage.
Don't do that again.
One can become very slippery from the extra water. Nice job from Posadsky to recognize that.
Mike, are you ready? Ready. Fight.
Round number two.
Well, we said the stand-up of Zhanikov was... Oh, spinning nice spinning kick there.
Spinning back fist just missed. Ovsyannikov tried to take advantage on the level change. Instead, taken down on the counter takedown from Musayev.
Ovsyannikov did the wrong thing there. He should have kept his distance, kept well out of the way, because we said at the beginning that his stand-up looked quite crisp and clinical. But went into a brawl, attempted the takedown, got took down to his back again.
We saw a lot of this in round number one, and here we are with this in round number two. Ovsyannikov on his back, fighting out of open guard, now being stacked by Shamil Musayev.
Ovsyannikov will probably feel a little bit desperate here. He realized that he couldn't submit Musayev in the first round.
But he had no real commitment on the submission attempts. He's active opening guard, closing guard, but he's not walking his legs up. He's really not hunting.
Well, to be honest, I think Musayev is doing really well to defend it. Every time he feels the legs go high, you can see his elbows cramp over the top of the thighs, which stops him allowing to get the legs around and over for the triangle or for the armbar. So he's actually spoiling the submission attempt, is Musayev.
Ovsyannikov trying to throw from the bottom position. Big right hand to the body from Shamil Musayev.
There's again with the legs. You're trying to, every time that Musayev lifts his hand up, there's a submission attempt going, but Musayev just knows what he's doing. He's quite clinical there. There's a triangle attempt.
Good recognition from Musayev, pulling his head out of danger and out of range.
It's got to be very frustrating for Ovsyannikov. He knows what he's doing. He's trying to do it, but with his head cramped up against the ring there, and Musayev spoiling everything he's doing, it's got to be very frustrating for him. Because you can see he knows what he's doing. He knows what to do. He knows what he's trying for. And obviously when he's in the gym or in other fights that he's had, he's probably pulled off great submissions. Musayev is just one step ahead of him.
Mark the Hammer Coleman, recognized as the inventor of the ground and pound, but Ian, you're certainly there in that lineage. You're one of the first fighters to dominate with ground and pound, and you recognize its positional awareness from the top to keep your beast not being allowed to get caught in a triangle, caught in an armbar, or more importantly, swept.
Well, that's exactly what you do with the ground and pound. A lot of people think once you're in the guard, you just throw punches and, you know, make them hit the head, but you've got to be aware of everything that's going on. You've got to make sure that your elbows are not going too far on the inside so that you get caught in a triangle. You know, if the legs come up high, you've got to try and push them back. You know, you've got to throw punches and be aware of submissions at exactly the same time.
Was the back of the head, didn't you?
Łukasz Posadski warning of Ovsyannikov for a punch to the back of the head, just tapping with the right hand, but still, it hit in that area along the crown to the nape of the neck, which is illegal. 2 minutes remaining, round number two.
I just love the way Musayev is actually controlling this fight in the corner, as he did earlier in round one with his head up against the cage. That's awareness, that's ring control.
And Mikhail Ovsyannikov is just simply stuck. You see, he's in the corner, nowhere to turn. He's trying to be active. Musayev, great positional awareness and recognition. It's not necessarily, Ian, that he's being heavy with his top game. He's being effective with his base.
The only thing Ovsyannikov, I think, should try to do is stand up from this position. He's trying submissions from this position, but they're not working. So now what he should be doing is using the corner post to stand back up, as you do when you're in a cage. You know, you use the fence, you use the cage to help stand back up. There's no reason why he can't use the corner post to do the same thing.
A lot of redness on the face now of Ovsyannikov. He's taken some big shots, small shots, and medium shots from Musayev, but it's amounting to a tremendous volume of punches and hammer fists here in round two.
Well, that's the thing, Sean. It doesn't have to be huge, devastating punches all the time. It's the volume of punches that you take. It's the volume that wears you down. Everyone has an energy bar, and every time that you get hit with those punches, that energy bar gets weaker and weaker, and this is exactly what's happening in this fight.
Ovsyannikov, again, I'll use the word, he is stuck in this position. Trying to be active with his legs, again, opening his guard, walking his legs up, repositioning his ankles and closing his guard. Shamil Musayev does not move. You see the base of the Russian, posturing on his left knee, getting that puncher's base.
Well, they say this is an amateur fight, but what Musayev is doing is definitely professional, because every time he is controlling the head before he strikes, every time he's controlling the head up against the cage, every time there's a submission, he's spoiling the movement of the legs of his opponent. This is something that you don't pick up overnight.
Final seconds of this round. Most likely the final seconds of this lightweight tournament final. There's the bell. There is the possibility of an overtime round if this is even on the three judges' scorecard.
That is a bronze prize in the category of 70.3 kilograms. Nikola Kuznetsov, Ukraine, and Tamazi Bocharashvili, Georgia. Для награждения спортсменов в ринг приглашается герой Российской Федерации Валерий Николаевич Чухванцев, а также президент Федерации ММА Киргизии Улугбек Амурзаков.
Бойцы на середину. Уважаемые поклонники боевых искусств, в этом поединке единогласным решением судей одержал победу и стал чемпионом Европы по ММА 2016 года. Весовой категории 70,3 килограмма. Спортсмен из России Шамиль Мусаев. Наши аплодисменты, наши поздравления и заслуженные призы и подарки. Пожалуйста, Валерий Николаевич, вручайте, награждайте нашего чемпиона. Шамиль, аплодисменты! Мы поздравляем серебряного призера, спортсмен из Германии, Мишель Овсянников. Наши аплодисменты! Ну и, конечно же, по традиции у нас два третьих места. Спортсмен из Украины Николай Кузнецов. Николай, наше поздравление. И Тамази Бочарашвили, Грузия. Наши аплодисменты. Традиционное общее фото на память. Мы поздравляем ребят, мы поздравляем их команды. Все вместе, прошу вас. А мы аплодируем, а мы приветствуем. Молодцы! Спасибо огромное. Наши поздравления. Ну, если можно, Валерий Николаевич, два слова, коротко.
Ну что, любой спорт – это красиво, а единоборство – это ближе к нам, к мужчинам. Мы должны защищать себя, свою семью, ну и свою страну, и гордиться. Спасибо всем, кто любит этот спорт.
Спасибо вам, что вы с нами. Улыбек Сержки зашел. Спасибо. Спасибо огромное, наши чемпионы. Спасибо. Официальным транспортным партнером турнира является компания «Таксовичков». Такси «Таксовичков» является одним из лидеров пассажирских перевозок в Санкт-Петербурге. Компания предлагает свои
иногда
просто качественный сервис, а революционный вид транспорта, соединяющий в себе низкую стоимость поездок, удобство, высокую скорость подачи. Элементы VIP-класса в каждом автомобиле.
Разные классы автомобилей. Эконом, комфорт, бизнес, VIP, минивэн. Сверхбыстрая подача машины. Бесплатный Wi-Fi во время поездки. Цены от 150 рублей. Таксовичков. Любимое такси Петербурга. 333-0000.
Партнер турнира — региональная общественная организация «Ньюстрим. Новый поток». «Ньюстрим. Новый поток» создан с целью содействия инициативам и достижениям молодежи в области физической культуры и спорта, популяризации здорового образа жизни, воспитания патриотического, спортивного, соревновательного духа. «Ньюстрим. Новый поток». Спорт – это жизнь.
Петербург. Первое деловое радио. 107.4 FM.
Чайный сик «Титон». Достойная оправа для превосходного чая и изысканный атрибут современного гурмана. Титон, вкус к совершенству. Благодарю вас за внимание, господа. I was wondering for the day that you'll be back, you will be mine, and the end I show you all mine. Уважаемые поклонники боевых искусств, представляем вашему вниманию финальный бой чемпионата Европы по ММА 2016 года. Весовая категория 77,1 килограмма. Спортсмен в синем углу ринга. Внимание на экран.
Ассаламу алейкум, мэн Джундуз Набиев. Бенис Алгар Дэвид Чепсин, полифинала кыстым. Полифиналда Ermeni Dumanısına galip geldim. Seksaksiyana galip geldim. İnşallah final dövüşünde Azerbaycan'ın layığını da temsil edeceğim.
Приветствуйте, Гундуз Набиев, Азербайджан! В основном углу ринга представляет Российскую Федерацию. Знакомьтесь, господа, внимание на экран.
Я Хирамагамедов Гаджимурат, представляю сборную России. Вышел в финал. Хотел бы поблагодарить тренеров, своих личных тренеров и тренера сборной, главного тренера сборной Геннадия Павловича, Шамиля Алибатырова и нашего всеми любимого доктора Елены Павловны. В финале покажу все, что могу, попытаюсь выступить на все 100%, как и делаю обычно.
Приветствуйте, Гаджимурат Хирамагомедов, Россия!
Спокойно, новый прием!
строй бойца. Готовы все пробудили сильный пацан. Тут на леса победы и горечи поражений. От старых достижений до следующей мишени. В любом расположении бить и быть на пике. И только цель в конце, а не сожжите. Разве сомнения лучше на этом рифе. Я в чемпионской лиге писать себя в список великий. Сколько это лучше ей всех наград. Он не всегда по плану, но никогда наугад. Ты долго пахал, почему я ударом крат. Оппонент по скорому брат, с первой минуты не рад.
Итак, господа, двухраундовый финальный бой с возможным дополнительным третьим экстрем раундом в весовой категории 77,1 килограмма. Представляю вам спортсменов. Спортсмен в синем гуринга. Ему 21 год. Рост 178 сантиметров. Он чемпион Азербайджана по смешанным боевым единоборствам. В синем углу Гундуз Набиев, Азербайджан. И его соперник в красном углу, ему 25 лет, рост 177 сантиметров. Он чемпион России по ММА, обладатель Суперкубка России по ММА, чемпион мира по смешанным боевым единоборствам. Приветствуйте, Гаджимурат Хирамагомедов, Россия в красном углу. Рефери в ринге Виктор Корней, Санкт-Петербург, Россия.
Бойцы на центр. Парни, слушай внимательно, работаем. Два раунда по 5 минут. Возможным экстра раундом. Еще раз напоминаю, головой бить нельзя. По затылку, позвоночнику бить нельзя. Локтем можно бить, по корпусу, по ногам. В партере коленом и ногой работаем только по корпусу, по ногам. Шорты, перчатки, каната не хватаем. Слушай меня на протяжении всего боя. Пожали руки. Разойдись по углам.
Set now for the welterweight final of the 2016 WMMAA European Championships. At the Ice Palace in St. Petersburg, Russia. Tina Machine Freeman, I'm Sean Wheelock.
Are you ready?
In this welterweight tournament final, Gunduz Nabayev from Azerbaijan versus Gadzimurad Hiramagomedov from Russia. Black trunks for Nabayev, green red trunks for Hiramagomedov.
Hiramagomedov taking center of the ring.
Inside kick. It's very high and tight for Nabayev. To the inside comes Hiramagomedov. Looking for the hip toss, now hooking the leg.
Oh, beautiful throw. That was classic Sambo.
The throw would have looked a lot more spectacular in the center of the ring.
Yeah, well, to be honest, Nabayev was saved by the ring there because he hit the ropes and Hiramagomedov had to leave go.
Hands low, circling lateral movement now for Nabayev.
Nabayev is keeping out the way. He knows what the throws are like. He knows how good the Sambo is. He's trying to keep on the outside.
Jeff Nabayev. Magomedov very poised, looking to come back to the inside. He feints with the head. Kick just under the armpit. Hiramagomedov, though, in trying to close space, cutting off this ring.
He's doing really well by doing that as well. He knows exactly how to cut off the ring. You can watch another spectacular throw coming up. Oh!
Time called by referee Viktor Korneyev.
Well,
accidental knee to the cup of Hiramagomedov.
Well, that definitely spoiled the throw, Sean. Yeah, straight between the legs. Unfortunate. Hiramagomedov just threw a kick at the same time the knee was thrown.
Korneyev hammer fisting the bottom of the feet. Gadzimurad Hiramagomedov. Ian, I've been watching this sport since UFC 1. I've commentated about 2,500 fights. I've never seen that before.
Maybe he was knocking the testicles from his feet. I'm not sure.
Whatever he did, it worked. He was given 5 minutes. He takes less than one. Time in. Round number one resumes. Something that I know.
Well, it's Nabayev that closes the distance.
Nabayev looking for a single leg now. Thought about an ankle pick. Overhook held by Hiramagomedov. Offensive base now from Gadzimurad Hiramagomedov.
Nabayev's got a good body lock. He needs to pull him away from the ropes. He's got double underhooks. The takedown attempt is inevitable now. He needs to hook that leg and pull him out, especially when he's sitting on the corner post like that. outside or inside hook to the legs and just pull it away from the corner post, that'll bring him down to his backside.
Kornaev just warned Nabayev for a low blow, but we fight on. Fierce body lock from Gunduz Nabayev. Magomedov. Good defensive grappling, keeping his feet in this position.
And Nabayev now is going for the trip. No, he's not. He's going for the single.
Fainted on the ankle pick, though, with the left-handed Nabayev.
Now he's got... He's obviously not too versed with the trip, Sean. He's got the body lock beautifully. He needs... Well, referee breaks it up.
Not enough action for Victor Kornia. Center ring restart. We resume round one. Magomedov trying to step in and says it's Nabayev the aggressor with this
fight. Oh, nice uppercut by him.
Short, sharp uppercut lands from here on Magomedov. He's good to this fight.
Nabayev keeping his distance.
145 remaining, round number one. Both fighters starting to throw now.
Here Magomedov just threw another two uppercuts there. Missing the mark though.
Nabayev very square to the target. Here Magomedov
needs to get up the corner.
Big body shot from here Magomedov.
Here Magomedov's doing really well to corner his opponent.
To the body.
Gets him in the corner again.
That landed flush. Nabayev walks through, comes back to the center of the ring. Outstanding here in round number one of this welterweight final.
The only downside I can say to Hiro Magomedov is once he's through the damaging punch, he backs off.
Right hand from Nabayev. That's his best punch of this fight. Right pop.
He wants him up on his feet.
Very tellingly, Ian not following Nabayev to the ground, and Nabayev really flopped to the ground in that position.
Beautiful shot to the liver. But see how he backs off, Sean? Once he's got caught in the corner post like that, he should keep him there. He can still keep his distance, punching from long range, but he seems to step back one or two steps to give his opponent time to move away.
Nabayev certainly got 25 seconds remaining.
Oh, nice liver kick.
Hard from Hiro Magomedov. Getting his striking going is the Russian Gatsimrod Hiro Magomedov.
Gets him down. Huge body shot. That's another shot. Victor Kornia taking over. Nice cross foot. Hiro Magomedov looking to finish. Final seconds, round number one. More big shots to the ground. Stop. There's the bell. The end of a ferocious
round. By the bell. Wow.
What a beautiful liver punch to the body. That actually doubled up Nabayev. He didn't really want to continue, but the guts and the glory, he just kept them moving out the way.
Nabayev was frozen on that body shot in the final minute of round number one from Hiro Magomedov.
He's coming in, Magomedov, but as he threw the knee, he got kicked in the groin, and there's a jumping knee to the head. He just kept keeping his opponent up against the corner post and just punished him with strikes. And there's a body kick again to the liver. That look weakened him before he threw the punch. And then the body shot of the punch comes in. That was the hurting blow. That doubled him up. And if you've ever been hit in the liver, you know how painful that is.
Eat them. Just literally can freeze the body. And you saw the freeze there from Gunduz Nabayev. To his credit, Nabayev off of his stool, ready for round number two. Welterweight tournament final here in St. Petersburg, Russia. Gunduz Nabayev of Azerbaijan versus Gatsimurad Hiro Magomedov of Russia. Slight delay, Victor Kornaev, the referee, wiping up the excess water in the corner of Hiro Magomedov. Wiping off the excess water off the body of Nabayev. Kornaev backing up Nabayev. Round number two.
Well, here Magomedov knows that he's weakened the body of his opponent. He should close the distance and try another body shot or throw them kicks. Because I think one more blow to that liver will be enough to stop this fight.
Nabayev very tentatively circling on the outside. Here Magomedov confidently coming to the inside. Nabayev snatching the overhook back against the ropes.
I don't think it's a really wise plan for Hiro Magomedov to do this. He needs to break free. There we go.
Just misses with the head kick, just misses with the right uppercut. Magomedov loading up his strikes from this middle range.
Yeah, you can see how his body is swaying to the left-hand side of his own body. He's gonna move down to the left and throw that body shot again. You can see it happening. He's loading up, getting ready. He's gonna corner his opponent again. Here we go.
Nabayev defensively circling, blocks that head kick deftly.
Yeah, Nabayev needs to be wary of where he's going to be in this ring.
Full stalking mode now from Gadzimirov, Nurmagomedov. Looking very confident. You see fainting as he's coming in.
Oh!
Almost rolling thunder on that cartwheel
kick. Yeah, cartwheel kick, Sean. Oh, again to the groin.
Accidental teep kick right to the cup of Nurmagomedov. Time called by referee Victor Korniev. And again, I think he's going to pound on the bottom of his feet. It worked the first time.
Well, that looked above the belt line, actually.
I think the heel caught the top of the cup, the toes or the flats of the feet, and I think caught above the waistline.
Oh, yeah.
It's the heel into the cup on the teep kick.
Halfy half.
Stand behind you.
We need to take that technique back to the UK and the United States respectively. It apparently works.
Well, does it work or does the rest does the rest while he's having his feet tapped? No, he's still getting a 30 seconds to a minute rest. Is he going to give him a yellow card? He's just giving a verbal warning, which will not affect the judges' scorecards.
So not a one-point deduction, just a strong verbal warning on the second low blow of this fight, given by Korniev to Nabayev. Round number two resumes.
Nice job.
Nabayev getting a bit more aggressive after the timeout.
He needs to be. He needs to get this takedown. He needs to control his fight now.
Collapsing the legs on the double leg, and he hits it. Good second effort.
Nurmagomedov still sitting upright, though. Not a bad position to be in if you are going to be on the canvas. Sitting upright like that, gonna very hard to get away from this position by Nabayev.
Korniev just called for action. Nurmagomedov, no doubt, would like a stand up, and there it is.
That's exactly what he got.
Applause from the St. Petersburg, Russia crowd. Want to see this fight continue to flow.
Oh.
Big uppercut by Nurmagomedov as Nabayev stepped into the pocket.
Timed that beautifully. Well, Nabayev has got where he wants to be, and that's in the clinch because he doesn't want to take them strikes, but he's taking punishment on the takedown also.
High on the single leg takedown. But Nabayev not really resisting, almost inviting Nurmagomedov to come to the ground. Nurmagomedov wants the fight to stand.
I think Nabayev is still hurt. I think that liver kick is still, that's only the liver punch is still hurting him. Oh, and again he gets caught with a liver.
It nearly ended the fight in the closing minute of round number one, that liver punch. Nurmagomedov trying to cut the angles. Now I have an explosion of offense, but then eats that shot. Now to the body lock, the waist inch, looking for the takedown is Nurmagomedov. Just throwing Nabayev down.
Nabayev looks as if he's just giving up hope.
No defense on that takedown from Nabayev. Nurmagomedov wants him to stand, and Nabayev does. Has no choice in that situation.
Nabayev's backing off to the corner again.
The evolution of mixed martial arts, both pro and amateur. If you're on the ground, you can no longer stay there. The other fighter does not want to engage you on the ground. You must stand up. That was the case there.
Well, Nabayev needs his takedown. He needs to control this fight. He's getting beat standing up. He's getting beat when he's on his back. So he needs to take top position.
Nice single leg attempt from Nabayev. Good balance, good base from Nurmagomedov.
Yeah, Nurmagomedov's not going to allow him to take him down. Nice switch. He gets it over.
Beautiful work from Nurmagomedov.
Again, that's the sambo. As soon as you go down to the bottom, you reverse him immediately.
Almost into the north-south. From side control now, fully into the north-south. That's an inverted triangle if he wants to look for it, does Hiro Magomedov.
Yeah, he could slip the legs under the head. Slips the legs under the head. He's got that inverted triangle or reverse triangle, as you call it also.
Big elbows landing on the bicep.
Another good submission from here is the Kimura. He could grab that arm. It's there. It's ready. It's free.
Those elbows on the arm. Shots of attrition. Full control now for Godzilla here on Magomedov. Unloading with shots. Victor Korniev taking a really close look. 10 seconds remaining in this fight.
Well, he heard the 10 seconds and he decided to slow down, not speed it up. Well, is that sportsmanship? Was that clever? Was that wise? He knows he's won the fight, Sean. So he was being more of a sportsman. Great work there by Hiro Magomedov.
Likely
the end of the
fight. Литва.
Under the rules here, the 2016 WMAA European Championships in the finals. Can go to an overtime round. This looks to be 2018 two rounds to Ivan Georgiou и почетный президент Федерации ММА Армении Гарегин Агабелян. Again, as we take you back to round number one. Nearly the start of a fight-ending sequence for Hiro Magomedov. That vicious liver shot to the body. Nabayev froze, almost collapsed Hiro
боевых искусств в этом поединке единогласным решением судей одержал победу и стал чемпионом Европы по ММА 2016 года весовой категории 77,1 килограмма спортсмен из России Хаджимурат Хирамагомедов. Наши аплодисменты и поздравления! Мы аплодируем всей российской сборной. Это еще одна победа в нашу копилку. Ну и, конечно же, награда. Награда победителю. Серебряный призер, боец из Азербайджана, Гундуз Набиев. Мы его поздравляем. Второе место. Весовая категория 77,1 килограмма. Ну и, конечно же, чествуем, поздравляем бронзовых призеров, их по традиции двое. Спортсмен из Латвии, Валерий Миколаускас, Латвия, и Саргис Варданян, Армения. Наши поздравления спортсменам и, конечно же, традиционное фото на память. Приглашаем всю команду и, конечно же, от имени наших ребят, от имени наших спортсменов хочется в очередной раз сказать огромное спасибо за подготовку наших героев, героев нашей сборной, главному тренеру сборной России по ММА Геннадию Капшаю. Спасибо от всей команды, Геннадий Павлович! Официальный спонсор сегодняшнего турнира – объединенная энергетическая компания ОЭК. Энергия людям.
Официальный спонсор турнира – объединенная энергетическая компания «Энергия людям».
Партнер сегодняшнего турнира – региональная общественная организация «Ньюстрим. Новый поток». «Ньюстрим. Новый поток» создан с целью содействия инициативам и достижениям молодежи в области физической культуры и спорта, популяризации здорового образа жизни, воспитания патриотического, спортивного, соревновательного духа. «Ньюстрим. Новый поток». Спорт – это жизнь. Мы приветствуем всех, кто только что к нам присоединился, и представляем ваше внимание финальный бой чемпионата Европы по смешанному и боевому единоборству ММА 2016 года. Весовая категория 84 килограмма. Средний вес. Представляем спортсмена в синем углу ринга.
Я Горло Чилан, представляю Украину, выступаю в категории 84 килограмма, прошел финал, буду драться в финале с русским бойцом, ну, надеемся, бой будет очень хороший, смотрите нас.
В синем углу ринга спортсмен из Украины, приветствуйте, Иван Горлач! Дамы и господа, спортсмен в красном углу ринга представляет Российскую Федерацию. Его приветствие. Внимание на экран.
Я Шамиль Абдуллаев, представляю сборную России в категории 84 килограмма, а также клуб «Крепость». Хотелось бы поблагодарить руководство клуба «Крепости», а также всех моих друзей и родственников, которые болеют и поддерживают меня, а также всем ребятам из Владивостока. Россия, вперед!
В красном углу ринга спортсмен из России, встречайте, Шамиль Абдуллаев!
Спорта и конца, новые истории, я значит новый формат. Идет для молодых легенд, открытие врат, перезвешенных боев и комбинированных атак. Да это так, спорт достойных мужчин, да это так. Тут вера, воля, дух и патриотизм. Видать, избавлять вниз, но продолжить отбраться. Достижение цели, лучшая мотивация. Для чемпиона, сколь соперника, крышит он знает. Победа над собой, ему важнее, чем медаль. Где боли, сил не жаль, судьбы удар держать. При неудаче на боев подарить. Каждый из нас свою воин и уже чемпион. Нам не просто клетка ринг или октагон. Заряженный кулак, как боевой батон. Подгон, новый заряд, свобода, новый прием.
Итак, господа, двухраундовый бой с возможным дополнительным третьим экстра-раундом. Это средний вес, весовая категория до 84 килограммов. Представляю вам спортсменов. Спортсмен в синем углу, ему 20 лет. Рост 185 сантиметров. Он чемпион Украины по ММА. Приветствуйте, Иван Дурлач, Украина! Его соперник в красном углу, ему 26 лет, рост 180 сантиметров. Он трехкратный чемпион России по смешанным боевым единоборствам. Представляет Российскую Федерацию в красном углу ринга Шамиль Абдуллаев! Рефери в ринге Ян Воборник, Чехия.
Fighters! Hi, gentlemen. You have 2 5-minute rounds to fight, maybe extra round. But think about the best way to take a win is always to finish your opponent. Go back to the corner.
Here we go with the middleweight tournament final. Ivan Gorlash of Ukraine versus Shamil Abdullayev of Russia. The 2016 WMMAA European Championships from Ice Palace in St. Petersburg, Russia. Round number one. Black trunks for Gorlash, green red trunks for Abdullayev.
Oh, I didn't like the way Gorlash put his head down. He threw punches, put his head looking down to the canvas. He was trying to close the distance. Oh, you look down at the floor, you can't see punches coming.
Inside kick from Abdullayev. Good body kick from Gorlash. Abdullayev effectively spinning out of the corner, pulling this fight back to the center of the ring. Bounce in the step of the Russian Shamil Abdullayev.
Abdullayev, yeah, in the southpaw stance, throwing that beautiful liver kick.
Thudding to the body.
Using the back power leg. Which is what he Gorlash coming in again like that with his head down.
Easily defended on that attempt from Abdullayev. You see he wants space and he wants to pull this fight to the center of the ring here.
Again with that liver kick. Using the advantage of that back power kick, the back power leg. Always effective, southpaw against orthodox.
Quick kick in a quick straight. Body just misses.
I wonder how long it'll take Abdullayev to realize all he has to do is throw the big uppercut when Golash actually comes forward, because his head is always looking downwards.
Hard inside kick from Abdullayev. Borlash just not seeing that back kick, that left kick of Abdullayev.
Abdullayev, there again, his head's down again. It's, he might get away with it in the amateur ranks. He needs to be very careful though. But beautiful work by Abdullayev. He gets the takedown. Nicely beautiful. Done.
Beautiful turn to the body, the takedown right into side control. 2 minutes gone, round number one of this middleweight tournament final. Abdullayev took a defensive position, turned it into offense, a takedown, and landed into side control. Now neon
knee
belly.
Wide.
See the top control looking to step over into full mount. Shamil Abdullayev. Close guard now from Gorlash.
Abdullayev with his hands on the inside, the same control in the bicep of his opponent. Again with that leg postured up so he gets more power. Elbows to the body allowed in this amateur tournament.
Big left hand from Abdullayev. Gorlash trying to control the head of Abdullayev with his left hand, but having no effect. Abdullayev continuing to throw left hands, right hands machine.
I like the way that Abdullayev is controlling the arms of his opponent. Hands on the inside, grab the bicep.
Gorlash trying to throw from flat on his back out of closed guard. Generally, that is a losing strategy.
Yeah, of course, you can't really...
Stand up.
I'm surprised he stopped that. The action was quite good. It was flowing well.
So restart. Right. Both fighters back on their feet as ordered by referee Jan Vabornik.
Oh, nice body kick, but he gets taken to the canvas.
The kick was caught by Abdullayev. Hits that takedown. High on the single leg, high crotch off of the body kick.
Golash coming in very aggressively there.
Into north-south now from Abdullayev, flowing now back to side control. Looks very smooth as Shamil Abdullayev looking in from that top position.
But to be honest, he looks smooth at everything he's doing. His stand-up was smooth, his clinch work was smooth. He's gained every takedown thus far, and now in a good, strong side control position. Again.
Up to the body. Abdullayev, knee on belly. Would lead one to believe he's thinking about trying to pass in the full mount. Not snatching an arm. Hammer fist still knee on belly. Thought about moving the north-south now into the closed guard of Gorlash.
Yeah, Gorlash did well to re-guard down.
Abdullayev keeping his head low, forehead tucked into the chest. Continuing to throw from top position, body head with the right hand.
Look how he's got control of the arm there of Gorlash. He's got the hand on the bicep. Once your hand's on the bicep like that, they can't throw any punches back. They can't apply submission attempts. The only time you have to worry when you're in top position is when your arms is on the outside like that. That's when you can get submitted.
Closing seconds of this middleweight tournament final. Ivan Gorlash of Ukraine versus Shamil Abdullayev of Russia. And a big opening round for the Russian Abdullayev.
Yeah, clearly took that first round. No two ways about it. Well, this is where Abdullayev, he was going low to the inside leg, then went high for the head kick. There we go. But what he's doing, he's pretending to his opponent that he's going to stay low, goes high, but what a beautiful sit-down, takedown from the rear mount there. And this is the nice control he's got with hands on the inside, controlling the biceps, not allowing Gorlash to do any offensive work.
Burrison, the Netherlands, you see, the head official of the 2016 WMMAA European Championships.
Coach is out.
Set for round number two of this middleweight tournament final. Look at Abdullayev already to the center of the ring. Excess water being wiped off the body of Ivan Gorlash.
Thank you.
Jan Vabornik. Abdullayev was ready to go, Ian.
Well, I think Golash is going to come out strong. He came out strong at the end of round one because he knows he's down on points in the judges' eyes. He knows he's lost that round. He's only got one more round to gain dominance. So he's going to come out strong and hopefully go for the third.
Second round. Abdullayev again has to be backed up. He is ready for round number two. There's the bell. It's a sign of a confident, happy fighter. Very quickly out to the center of the ring.
Yeah, using that power leg again.
Abdullayev out of the southpaw stance. Showing the angle. She's loading up the back kick, that left kick, just like that.
Yeah, the southpaw stance is really strong for the liver kick, obviously, because they're throwing the leg on the side of the liver. And that's one of the main targets they always go for. It's a dominant, strong kick. Again to the body.
Bouncing the step of Abdullayev. From Abdullayev and that backed off Ivan Golash.
I thought Golash would have come out a little bit stronger now. He knows he's down around. He was stronger, came out stronger at the end of round one. I think those shots, those punches were just a fake to get the clinch, and he's got it. But let's see if he can finish it, Sean. Let's see if he can get that takedown.
Defensive base, defensive wrestling from Abdullayev, keeping his feet.
Abdullayev is strong, though. You can see the power in those clinch positions. Oh, nice left hand, straight down the pipe.
Ian, you see the contrast just in the striking stances. Golash much more square. Abdullayev fighting on angles allows him to do things like that.
Well, where Golash went wrong there, he shot in with his head looking down at the canvas again. So all Abdullayev had to do was push the face down into the mat, and that's where he ended up. The body will always follow the head. You push the head down, that's where the body's going to go. And Golash helped him by looking down at the canvas.
Tight inside control, left hand to the body from Shamil Abdullayev. Neon belly once more. And the step over, possibly trapping the left arm of Golash for crucifix. Counter defensive body lock from the bottom from Ivan Golash.
It's not going to work that well. He needs to do something other than hang on.
That's all a body lock is from the bottom in that position, just hanging on, playing defense. Neon belly, the pass is there for Abdullayev into full mount.
If he wants it, he can take it. I just don't think he wants it. He's quite happy to go knee ride. I think if he does go for mount position, he could finish this fight.
Strong side control, and there's the right hand to the head from Abdullayev. Golash playing all defense here in round number two.
There's the mount position. He needs to push the head down. He needs to control the head, cross face, put him down. Takes the rear mount.
Golash giving his back. One hook in now for Abdullayev. A lot of time remaining in round number two. 2:05 to the bell. Abdullayev thinking finish, thinking rear naked choke.
Oh, he takes the first hook out.
Being very patient though. Abdullayev trying to open up the chin, open up the neck of Ivan Golash with these punches.
Golash needs to be careful. He's reaching around and putting his hands between the leg of his opponent. You do that, you can actually get your leg trapped in sort of crucifix position from rear mount, but now in side control.
The only reason to reach through is a knee bar, and a knee bar was not there.
No, definitely not. Inexperience.
I think Husamir Palgaris could find the knee bar from that position, or Marcin Held.
Be careful.
Firm side control now for Abdullayev. Firm control of this fight for Shamil Abdullayev. Neon belly once more.
Yeah, Abdullayev, this is just textbook grappling. He's done this many times before, and he's finding it easy. He's not really being put off and pressured by his opponent, Golash. He knows this fight's in the back. A minute now to finish it.
Golash trying to shrimp from bottom position, starting to eat a lot of shots. Redness on the forehead of the Ukrainian Ivan Golash.
Well, you see, he's trying to shrimp, but he's doing it totally wrong. His movement is just not correct at all. He's actually trying to carry the weight of his opponent, and it's not working.
Closing stages of round number two of this middleweight tournament final.
Oh, big punches. You can hear them here from our comedy side.
Again, if we're level on the three judges' scorecards after two rounds, we'll go to an overtime round. That seems highly unlikely at this stage. 10 seconds remaining now. Full control for Shamil Abdullahian. Dominant with his top position from side control. There's the bell, and presumably the end of the fight. We shall see, but I think that's a clean two rounds.
Two rounds. Double domination on the ground.
В ринг приглашаются бронзовые призеры из категории 84 килограмма. Жуан Вилла, Испания. И Клаудио Аничарико, Италия. Для награждения спортсменов в ринг приглашается президент Федерации ММА Ленинградской области Виктор Данишевский и президент Федерации ММА Испании Чита Мордио.
Well, Golash is trying for the takedown every single time, but his head is looking down at the canvas, which is easy to control when someone does that. How to get the big man off him.
Бойцы на середину. Уважаемые поклонники смешанных боевых единоборств, в этом поединке единогласным решением судей одержал победу и стал чемпионом Европы по смешанному боевому единоборству ММА 2016 года. В среднем весе спортсмен из России Шамиль Абдуллаев! Наши аплодисменты Шамилю, всей команде и отдельные приветствия летят во Владивосток, где я знаю, что сегодня болею даже в эту минуту, несмотря на разницу во времени. У него огромное количество поклонников во Владивостоке. Передаем большой-большой привет всей федерации и, конечно же, поздравляем победителя. Второе место, Иван Горлыч, Украина. Наши поздравления, наши приветствия. И, конечно же, мы награждаем бронзовых призеров. Спортсмен из Испании Жуан Вилла, а также спортсмен из Италии Клаудио Аничарико. Бронзовые призеры, весовая категория до 84 килограммов. Общее фото на память, а у нас с вами, друзья, есть возможность поаплодировать и поздравить наших победителей. Очередная победа в копилку сборной России! Уважаемые поклонники боевых искусств, представляем вашему вниманию финальный бой чемпионата Европы по ММА 2016 года. Весовая категория до 93 килограммов. Представляем вам спортсменов. И первым появится спортсмен в синем углу. Внимание на экран!
Mein Name ist Robert Lau, ich bin 18 Jahre alt. Ich trainiere bei Integra in Wittlich. Und ich repräsentiere die deutsche Nationalmannschaft im Halbschwergewicht und bin sehr froh, dass ich heute ins Finale kommen konnte. Und ich werde alles dafür geben, wirklich alles, um diesen Titel mit nach Hause zu holen.
Приветствуйте, спортсмен из Германии, Роберт Лау!
Уважаемые дамы и господа, внимание на экран. Спортсмен в красном углу ринга представляет Российскую Федерацию.
Я Магомед Шахудинов, представляю сборную России. Вышел в финал и сделаю все возможное, чтобы победить. Болейте за меня.
Приветствуйте, Магомед Шахрутдинов, Россия! Итак, господа, это финал весовой категории до 93 килограммов. Два раунда с возможным дополнительным раундом. Представляю вам спортсменов. Спортсмен в синем углу. Ему 18 лет. Рост 185 сантиметров. Он чемпион Германии по смешанному боевому единоборству ММА. Ваши аплодисменты! Роберт Лау! И его соперник в красном углу, ему 26 лет, рост 175 сантиметров. Он чемпион России по вольной борьбе. Мастер спорта международного класса по вольной борьбе. Серебряный призер чемпионата России по ММА. Приветствуйте, Магомед Шахрутдинов, Россия! Рефери в ринге Лукаш Босаски, Польша!
Okay, fighters, no rules. Listen to my commands all the time. When I say stop, we stop. Touch those. Go back to your corners.
Back.
Robert Lau of Germany versus Magomed Shahrudinov of Russia. The light heavyweight tournament final. The 2016 WMMAA European Championships. The bell in round number one. From St. Petersburg, Russia.
Oh, Lau nice in the black trunks. By Lau.
Gray trunks with red trim for Shahrudinov.
Lau come out with a beautiful strong low kick there, Sean. Both of the stance on these guys are low. Shahrudinov, I think, going to look for the shot. I said it just as he did it. He come in with a real low stance.
Good effective sprawl from Lau.
And a body lock.
Lau short to the inside. Trying to turn knee to the body from Shahrudinov.
Yeah, Lau used his common sense there by sitting on the corner post.
There's the takedown with commitment on the second effort from the body lock.
Yeah, Shahrudinov done real well, now landing in half guard. Lau looking for the Kimura, but it's going to be very hard to put on from a half guard position. He could sweep him from here though once he gets it locked in.
Lau committed to that Kimura, posturing on his hip, but eating a lot of shots to the ribcage from Shahrudinov.
Yeah, he's let go of it now, Sean. He's realized he was taking too much punishment. in the process.
Now holding a loose half guard. Modified body triangle on the leg in the half guard. Interesting guard game from Lau.
Well, Lau was actually working the butterfly then.
The finger?
He couldn't get the sweep, so he then went for a body lock to hold onto his opponent. Is he going to do the holding tactic, or is he going to try and get a sweep from me in there? He tried to sweep. He tried to throw him there with no success, though.
Right body lock from Lau. Shurudinov looking very comfortable, though, in top position. Literally walking Lau into the corner, trapping him at the corner, at the turnbuckle against the lower fence.
With the guard wide open, Shurudinov can actually pass if he wants. Oh, big right hand.
Thunderous shots now from Shurudinov.
Well, Lau had to let go of his opponent just to protect his face because the punch was that hard. Again, as we see, they put their head up against the cage part of the ring. Like you say, you put it on an angle like that, it's very hard to defend anything.
Referee Łukasz Bosacki taking a close look at those shots from Shurudinov. They are landing firm and flush in.
Yeah, Shurudinov has him in a good position. That's why he didn't pass, because he knew once he got his head up against the ring, he knew he was going to be in a dominant controlling position in the years. Look at the head control as well. He's got cross face. Hand is on the shoulder or the tricep. Control the face, throw down with the other hand.
Now again, opening his guard, walking up, looking for the triangle, can't find it. Shurudinov clearing the legs effectively into side control.
Time.
Now time called by Bosacki.
Go to the go there.
The glove has come off the fingers of Lau.
Slipped out of the thumb. As you see, the whole hand
has come out of the glove.
Thing that he's wearing those yellow boxing hand wraps is the German Robert Lau.
Yeah, it's unusual to see MMA fighters wearing boxing hand wraps. Normally it's bandages and tape only. Obviously it's amateur, they may allow the amateur to wear these. But Lucas should put them back down in the side control position once he's...
Okay. Come back.
That's exactly what he's going to do. Yeah. Great referee from Łukasz Bosacki. The glove malfunction from Lau, he should not be rewarded for that situation. There's the proper restart. Round one resumes. Shurudinov right back to work with the elbow now to the right hand.
Lau pulls guard, half guard.
Lau likes to triangle his legs from half guard. Not that conventional. You'd be very defensive when you use the triangle.
Well, when you catch someone in half guard like that, Sean, it's okay if you're trying a submission attempt from top, but not from ground and pound. It's not going to make any difference whatsoever with ground and pound. Actually, a half pound.
See the heavy pressure now from Magomed Shurudinov. Just no space for Lau.
That's why Shurudinov's not really bothered if he passes that half guard. The ground and pound is strong. He knows it's strong and he can stay there all day.
Big hammer fist now from Shurudinov. Final minute, round number one. You see Lau posturing on his hip, stuck in that position against the corner cushion, against the turnbuckle.
Yeah, it's not a good position to be in.
The end could be near now. Shurudinov opening up with the right hand. Bosacki taking a really close look. Shurudinov looking to finish Lau, reestablishes his guard. Back to the left hand for Shurudinov.
Yeah, at least Lau was aware of what was going on. He might have been taking punishment, but he managed to re-guard his opponent, which means he's avoiding punishment. He's trying to move out there. It's not intelligently defending yourself. You're doing really well to move into full guard.
20 seconds now remaining, round number one. Can close guard for Lau. One way traffic at the moment for the Russian in his home nation is we're in St. Petersburg, Magomed Shurudinov. The bell cannot come soon enough for Lau. And there it is.
Well, Lau's trying to get back to his feet in the last second.
You need to do something with that.
He's not good at doing it, but
fight like that.
To be honest, the Russians are just taking full control of this amateur tournament right now.
I don't want this, coach. I don't want this.
The theme of round number one in Dedian, the theme of the night in these tournament finals, top control from Russian fighters.
Yeah, top control. I mean, look at the body lock. He gets a beautiful takedown here. And then once they're on the ground, it's just all control. I mean, look at the way he's controlling the head and controlling the neck of his opponent. You control your opponent's head, there again, he's doing it again. Shamudinov is controlling the head, although he's controlling the mouth as well. He's stopping his opponent from breathing, which is perfectly legal. He's also controlling the head. You control the head, it leaves you wide open for good shots.
We might have a slight delay here. Robert Lau is completely re-wrapping with the assist of his corner. That boxing hand wrap on his right hand. Still have to get his right glove back on. We are going to have a delay. Posadski, nicely done. Calls time. Sent Shurudinov to the neutral corner. It's a really good bit of refereeing from Łukasz Posadski, which I always appreciate.
Give me a towel. Give me a towel.
Excess water being wiped off the body of Lau. We're ready to start round.
Fight.
There's the bell. Light heavyweight tournament final 2016 WMMAA European Championships. With Ian the Machine Freeman, I'm Sean Wheelock. We're in St. Petersburg, Russia. Robert Lau of Germany versus Magomed Shurudinov of Russia.
Well, Lau has to watch the takedown, but he's still got a throwdown. Oh, nice. Big right hand to get the takedown. He got the clinch.
Right hand to close space. Now Shurudinov again looking to finish. Jackhammer left hand.
Just relentless on that ground and pound. We've got to give Lau his credit. He's still defending well.
Heavy volume of heavy strikes for Shurudinov in round one and again here in round number two. 45 seconds into this round.
Again, if you watch Shurudinov, he controls the head before he punches it. He controls it with one hand. There he's doing it now. Controls it with one hand and then throws down with the other. There's the control. There's the other. Perfect ground and pound. He's using the forearm to control the head of Lau.
A great head position by Magomed Shurudinov. You see that with a lot of wrestlers in mixed martial arts. It's not a headbutt. It's perfectly legal. You're using your head as a pivot to close space and control.
Yeah, use head control to control the head. You can use forearm control to control the head. You can actually cross face with the forearm across the face so they can't move. But every time they do that, they're doing it for a purpose. They're doing it to set up punches. And this is perfect ground and pound.
Posadski just said to Lau, you need to defend yourself. You need to fight back. Posadski letting Robert Lau know that if he does not fight back, Posadski is going to stop this fight. Shurudnikov is going to win by TKO. Looks like we're getting very, very close to that situation. Yeah. Magomed Shurudinov continuing to land big shots. Again with the left hand.
Just total domination here. Trying to trap the arm.
That left hand getting through from Shurudinov.
And you just wonder whether Shurudinov can understand English, because Lucas is speaking in English. For him to defend himself, if he could hear that or could understand that, he may throw down a little bit more leather. There's a big right hand. Yeah, Łukasz Posadski is looking well over the top. He's not happy with what's happening. He knows that Lau is taking punishment.
Lau is just not offering any. Just stuck in bottom position. A wipeout for Magomed Shurudinov in this light heavyweight tournament final. But still we fight on. 205 remaining round two.
But Shurudinov, it's the way he's controlling his opponent. That's what's working really well for him. Obviously the striking's doing great. But if you punch without the control, then it makes it look that Lau can escape, Lau can get out of there. But because he can't get out of there, it looks like he's not defending. And that's why Posadski said he must do something, otherwise he'll stop the fight. There's another control. Control in the head, bang with the right hand.
A totally defensive close guard for Lau. All he's doing is keeping Shurudinov in place to continue to rain down strikes.
Don't grab the throat. Don't grab the throat.
Magomed Shurudinov, so heavy with the top position.
There's the tape coming off the glove again.
Time called once more by Łukasz Posadski.
This is the exact reason why they shouldn't be wearing hand wraps.
That was the next sentence out of my mouth, Machine.
It should be bandaged and taped up.
Okay, are you ready, guys? Fight!
Here comes the restart.
Well, the referee knows that there's not long left in this round, and it's been two rounds of domination, so he knows it's not going to go into a third round. I just love the head control. Oh, that's a submission attempt, though, by Lau.
Tenth and presumably final minute of this fight, unless Lau can somehow score a finish. This has been all Magomed Shahrudinov. Of course, in the finals of the 2016 WMMAA European Championships, an overtime round is there if level after two rounds, but believe me, we're not privy to the judges' scorecards. No way this is level. This is all Magomed Shahrudinov.
Yeah, Shahrudinov just passes now to half guard.
And an argument can be made this is a 10-8 round right now for Shahrudinov. But for the 3Ds, damage, domination, duration, I think we've met that criteria.
Without a doubt. And look where Shahrudinov's got the outside knee. You put the outside knee under the armpit of your opponent. It's a good, strong base. Legs are wide. Opens the leg wide, which brings your hips down. Makes you heavy on top of your opponent. And Shahrudinov is doing all of that. All of the above. And then he's finishing off with strong ground and pound.
There's the bell. And that's literally everything but the finish for Magomed Shahrudinov. Credit to Robert Lau. Fought very well to reach this light heavy. The German on the bottom against Magomed Shahrudinov. The Russian looked outstanding.
Призеры весовой категории до 93 килограммов Павел Масальский, Республика Беларусь, и Дмитрий Микуца, Украина. Для награждения спортсменов в ринг приглашается вице-президент Всемирной Федерации смешанного боевого единоборства ММА Алихан Яндиев и президент Федерации ММА ГАМАФ Германии Адриан Бакос.
The ground and pound was superb, the control was superb, everything but the finish was there, even his positioning was perfect.
Уважаемые поклонники смешанных боевых единоборств, в этом поединке по итогам двух раундов единогласным решением судьи одержал победу и стал чемпионом Европы по ММА 2016 года в весовой категории до 93 килограммов. Спортсмен из России Магомед Шахрудинов! Россия!
Extremely impressive from Magomed Shahrudinov.
Наши поздравления всей команде, которая готовила Магомеда. И, конечно же, мы награждаем спортсмена из Германии. Роберт Лау стал серебряным призером в этой же весовой категории. А также наши поздравления спортсменам, которые стали бронзовыми обладателями в этой же весовой категории. Это Павел Масальский, Беларусь, и Дмитрий Микуца, Украина. Наши поздравления, ребята. Традиционное общее фото на память. Все вместе, пожалуйста. А мы аплодируем. А мы поздравляем ребят. И впереди у нас всего один бой чемпионата Европы. Благодарим официального спонсора сегодняшнего турнира. Объединенная энергетическая компания ОЭК. Энергия людям.
Официальный спонсор турнира. Объединенная энергетическая компания. Энергия людям.
Уважаемые поклонники смешанных боевых единоборств, представляем ваше внимание финальный бой чемпионата Европы по смешанным боевым единоборствам ММА 2016 года. Представляем спортсмена в синем углу ринга. Все внимание на экран.
Я Болдырев Евгений, представляю сборную Украины. Раша попал в финал. Соперник у меня хороший, так что боя легкого не будет. Будем показывать хороший бой для любителей ММА.
Приветствуйте, Евгений Болдырев, Украина! Спортсмен в красном углу ринга представляет Российскую Федерацию. Знакомьтесь, господа, внимание на экран.
Я Куниев Рязан, представляю сборную России на чемпионате Европы. Очень рад, что попал в финал. Постараюсь показать красивый зрелищный бой для любителей смешанных единоборств, для зрителей. Также хотел бы поблагодарить своих тренеров, это Шамиля Батырова, Сухаба Магомедова, Магомеда Магомедова, своих спарринг-партнеров, Куба Горец. Россия, привет!
Ризван Куниев, Россия в красном углу!
Как боевой батон, новый сей.
Итак, господа, это тяжелый вес, весовая категория свыше 93 килограммов, два раунда с возможным дополнительным экстра-раундом. Представляю вам спортсменов, спортсмен в синем углу, ему 32 года, рост 190 сантиметров, он чемпион Украины по боевому самбо, призер Кубка мира по боевому самбо. Приветствуйте, Евгений Болдырев, Украина! Его соперник в красном углу. Ему 24 года, рост 191 сантиметр. Он чемпион России по ММА, серебряный призер чемпионата Европы по ММА, бронзовый призер чемпионата мира по смешанным боевым единоборствам. Представляет Российскую Федерацию Ризван Куниев! Рефери в ринге Марко Брурсон, Королевство Нидерланды.
Red corner, blue corner, center of right. You both know the rules, listen to my command. Protect yourself all times, make it a good match. Shake hands, step back to your corner.
The heavyweight tournament final of the 26th European Petersburg, Russia.
Judge.
Evgeny Boldarev of Ukraine versus Ryzvan Kunaev of Russia. The bell in round number one. Black trunks for Boldarev, green red trunks for Kuniev.
Oh, Kuniev goes high. You don't normally say that for big guys.
Outside low kick now from Kuniev.
Retaliated with a body kick.
Kick nearly caught. Kuniev already in, trying to cut off the ring. You see, working the angles on Boldarev.
I don't like the way Boldarev is cowering when the punches are coming in. Look, when you cover up like that, looking down to the floor, cowering just a little bit, your counter-attack is not that good. Although he may be strong on the attack, the counter-attack is not going to be that great when you cover up.
Southpaw stands for Boldarev, lands the body kick to Kuniev, then Kuniev responds by closing distance.
I'm surprised that Kuniev got the distance close, to be honest. You think, watching Boldarev cower up a little bit like that, he might have threw a bit more leather, a few more hands, but now he's quite happy to get the clinch. But this is a big guy to try and take down.
Referee Marco Burrison doing a good job controlling the ring ropes in this heavyweight tournament final.
Action!
Call for action now from Burrison. Punch on the thigh after two to the body with the right hand from Kuniev. It's a smart tactic, I always think, in MMA, Ian, going with punches to the legs. It's not an obvious target, but it's a punch of attrition. There's the center ring separation from Burrison and the restart.
Well, let's see how Boldarev. Oh, big right hand. Well, Boldarev's got good attack.
Boldarev just missing with the left cross out of that southpaw stance. Kuniev definitely the aggressor in the striking coming forward.
Oh, that was powerful. You could hear that.
Or just under the armpit. Kuniev getting off with his kicks from the conventional right-handed stance.
Look at the welt on the under the armpit there, Boldarev. Well, Boldarev, he's holding his own. He may be taking punishment, but he's giving it back also.
All stand up here in round number one of this heavyweight tournament final. Evgeny Boldarev of Ukraine versus Ryzvan Kuniev of Russia.
Kuniev looks as if he's looking for that big one shot.
Big wide punch from Boldarev to the body. Fainted on that leg kick, did not send it through.
That's the thing with these big heavyweights, Sean. They may only throw one or two punches at a time, but when they throw them, they're heavy. So Kuniev just looks like he's setting up the right hand and he's pulling back the trigger, ready for that big one shot.
1-2 right there from Kuniev. And the two to the right hand. Oh, oh, huge shot. The end is near. Big Burrison taking a really
Wow, look at the damage on the eye of Boldarev, or just below the eye. That's why he tapped. He took a big shot. The big shot sent him to the canvas. And Kunayev just finished off with some awesome striking. The hand came out and he tapped. He didn't want to take any more punishment. And Robert Brusen stepped in to stop the onslaught.
Brusen was about to stop this fight, give Kunayev the TKO win, but before that could happen,
приглашается президент Федерации ММА Чехии Михаил Хармсмит, а также президент Российской общественной организации Ньюстрим Новый Поток Юрий Навражный.
Доктор! Red corner.
Islam Kunayev takes this heavyweight tournament final. He takes this heavyweight tournament here in St. Petersburg, Russia, at the 2016 WMMAA European Championships. Kunayev was very patient machine. He did not rush. You could see early on he felt that he had the vastly superior striking, and he finally unloaded when he saw the opportunity.
Уважаемые поклонники боевых искусств, поединок длился 3 минуты 13 секунд. Нокаутом одержал победу в этом поединке и стал чемпионом Европы по ММА 2016 года. В тяжелом весе спортсмен из России Ришван Куниев. Наши поздравления, заслуженная награда, пожалуйста, вручаем Ризвану. Наши поздравления, он стал победителем, настоящим чемпионом Европы в этом году. И, конечно же, мы поздравляем Евгения Болдырева, поскольку он остается в шаге от победы. Второе место. Наши поздравления, друзья. Ну что ж, буквально через мгновение подведем командный итог. Через мгновение, дорогие друзья, будет командное награждение, которое состоится на сцене. А мы благодарим всех за участие. Спасибо вам огромное. M1 Challenge 71 стартует по расписанию 21.
Приветствую город как главный. Даже не представляете, кто сейчас в нашей студии. Да, кто Слушай Спорт FM в Санкт-Петербурге. Будь первым.